Welcome back to Gillette Stadium for the first time in a very long time, alongside with Karen Guregian. I'm Andrew Callahan for the Boston Herald. After a wild offseason, the Patriots lost Tom Brady. I lost my hair, but we are here.
I still have mine.
Yeah, you are very lucky. So here, the Patriots getting ready for the season opener, just 2 days away. Everyone knows the Dolphins are coming in. The last time that the Dolphins were here at Gillette Stadium, they beat the Patriots in the regular season to keep them out from a playoff bye, which we've heard a lot of this week, which has been fairly, you know, calm, but that's come up numerous times. It's not in the revenge sense, but it's just a sense of they know this Dolphins team can come in and beat them.
Well, I think that's a very important thing because they took them rather lightly in that important Week 17 game. I know this is a new season, but players do have long memories. Mm-hmm. Bill Belichick has a long memory.
The longest.
And I think that's the important thing. And I know it's a different cast for the Patriots, but I still think they want to get off on the right foot and perhaps send a message to the Dolphins that, hey, you're still beneath us.
To the new foot as well as along with the right foot with Cam Newton in town now as a quarterback. Cam has been the most interesting interview, at least as far as I've been on the beat now going in my third season. You, of course, been around the team since 2006. So I got to ask you, what kind of dynamic has he brought from your perspective? Because it's been totally new to me and foreign in terms of where he fits in now with the new Patriots.
Well, I think it's almost he's like the perfect guy to come in because he offers a completely different perspective. He's a completely different style of quarterback and a completely different personality than Tom Brady. And I think that the players immediately gravitated toward him and that personality. I mean, it's hard not to get enthused when Cam is kind of so engaged at practices. And I guess in the locker room as well. I mean, he's the first guy in, the last guy out. They named him a captain. And listening to him in the times that we have, it's easy to see why.
Yep. Cam is also fully healthy, which was a big question mark for his entire offseason before he got here into New England. And largely the Patriots are healthy too. Offensive tackle Yadni Kajust was put on IR yesterday. And so that's really the only absence we had seen at practice today. Everyone there, though, Julian Edelman's been limited. Stephon Gilmore was put in the injury report Thursday with a hamstring. Both seem to be expected to play. But, you know, just in case something crops up late, those are two names to remember going into kickoff for what overall should be a healthy Patriots team.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see, too, how safe the Patriots play it with those two very important players, Gilmore with a hamstring and Julian with a knee. As it is, they were trying to manage Julian's reps and practice time during training camp. So I will be very interested to see what happens in this particular game. I mean, they're loaded in the secondary, so, you know, it's possible they'll sit out Gilmore. But again, I think everyone wants to see his matchup with Devontae Parker.
Everyone wants to see football down here at Gillette Stadium. 2 days away. Mm-hmm. I can't wait. It's been great to be back, and we will see you on Sunday. Keep it here with the Herald. For Karen, I'm Andrew. Week 1 is here.